She acts, she writes, she even plays the violin. But Ramona Young is at Los Angeles Magazine, Hollywood's A-list. She made the A-list on the LA Magazine. Now, that's got to be an amazing experience to open up a magazine, Ramona, and say, what? I'm on the A-list? How'd that happen?
Yeah, I can't even believe it. I don't think it's really hit me yet. I'm just kind of going with the flow with the whole show and everything.
Oh, but you're so modest. I mean, never have I ever. It's a Netflix series. It's captured everybody's imagination. Great ensemble cast. Tell me what it feels like to be in such a winning cast with such a winning cast.
Honestly, it's one of the best casts that I've ever worked with. Everyone is extremely nice and everyone shows up and we always have a good time.
But there'll be a billion cocky nerds like Ben at Princeton. This is your one chance to hook up with a Paxton. And when you're old and on your deathbed, whose naked body do you want to be picturing?
On my deathbed, wouldn't I be thinking about my kids and grandkids and stuff?
No, that's a myth.
Even during COVID, we had to film through that. We were all just in good spirits still.
What's so amazing is the multicultural aspect of this show, and it actually, you know, it takes place in Sherman Oaks, and you know what? It's pretty much reflective of the way LA is, don't you think?
Yeah, that's one of the things that I really love about the show, and I think it's so important in media to portray diversity as it is in real life. So I feel really grateful to be a part of a show that does that.
And not only that, but the writing is fantastic. I mean, it just flows so well. It seems so natural. And it's like you actually are living through these kids.
Yeah, the writing is amazing. Mindy, of course, writes a lot of the episodes. So does Lang and Chris and everyone. Their comedic timing is on point. So the credit goes to them. I just kind of say what's written and it works out great because they're so funny.
You know, it's interesting that, you know, I would describe it as an ensemble cultural cast with secrets and antics and hijinks. That's how an old guy would describe your show. But this is season two, so you are onto something here.
Yeah, I feel like the show is watchable for everyone, like no matter like how old you are. I hear a lot of adults and mothers and parents actually say that they're a big fan of the show. So I think the comedy is pretty universal.
Now, you like to write. So tell me a little bit about your desire to write. What inspires you? What makes you put, you know, pen to paper or to computer?
Yeah. I've always written ever since I was little. I've kept a journal and I still do. And I feel like that has just transitioned into script writing and storytelling. I want to write stories that I haven't seen yet on screen that I want to.
What's interesting to me is that, you know, I know that the Indian culture is something that's not seen except maybe in Bollywood movies, and we have seen on occasion an Indian character, but this is fully, I mean, you're really immersing yourself in the culture, not only the food, but the practices, the religious beliefs, and the juxtaposition of what it's like to be in America. And now we're seeing this mixture of your culture and then your Latina partner also, her culture. Tell me about that intermixing of cultures and what we're learning as viewers.
Yeah, I think the show does integrate everyone's background to an extent. What I love about the show is that it makes it relatable so that no matter if you're from Italy or from France or from Mexico and you're watching the show, you still relate to this Indian American culture, even though you might not be from there.
Well, one of the quotes from the show is like, "We're glamorous women of color." I love that.
Yeah, we are.
But the nerdy aspect of it all too, it's like all these new shows that are showing young people as brainiacs. I mean, it's cool to be smart. And when I was younger, it seemed to be that, you know, there was always, oh, we got to go to school. Oh, you know, it was always played down, but now that has been elevated too.
Yeah, I think nowadays, what I value most is just being genuine and authentic and trying to be a good person. So whether that is being on the cheerleading team or being in band, it doesn't really matter. Like, what is cool is being authentic.
What in the world is John McEnroe doing in this program?
Yeah, he's the narrator for the leading character, my trainee, who plays Davey. So he narrates her inner thoughts throughout the series, and he does an amazing job.
It's a genius touch. I mean, I was listening to him and I'm thinking, why, that voice sounds familiar. You must be kidding. I mean, or you must be joking, which was his common thing when he was playing tennis. But it adds sort of a flavor of, yeah, inside of her mind, right?
Yes, so the character Davey kind of has this similar temperament as John McEnroe does. And also it relates to like her father and her father being a great fan of John McEnroe and his influence on Davey's life. So there's a lot of ties that go with that.
So how do you find working as a working actress in Los Angeles? You have a new film, The Prank, with Rita Moreno, one of the greatest stars of all time in America. Tell me what it feels like to be working steadily in a place that's as competitive as Hollywood.
I feel very fortunate. I try to stay humble because, like you said, like some of these legends that I get to work with and learn from, I still feel like I'm brand new at this, which in retrospect, I am compared to some of these people that I've worked with. So I just go in and I try to learn something from these great people.
Well, I think, your star is huge. You're already on the A-list of Los Angeles Magazine. What else could there be? What does your family think about all this?
I think they're very supportive. I think in the beginning, they were nervous for me, understandably. But now I think they're seeing like the bright sides of acting and they really want me to go for it. So I'm excited about that.
Well, Ramona Young, we wish you the very best. Again, this is Never Have I Ever, the second season on Netflix. I've thoroughly enjoyed it. You're terrific in it. And I wish you the very best. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thanks, Carlos. Have a great day.
You too.